Namaste. Today in this video we are going to discuss or we are going to learning about a Google form with a password protected. Many teachers know how to set a password in the Google form, but still so many teachers don't know how to set the password. It is very easy process. We are making questions in one section, and before that we have to add one more section. In that first section we have to set the password, and after typing the password we are going to the second section in which you can give the questions and options. Only this much. Very easy process. We can go to the video. Before going to the video, those who are watching this first time, my channel first time, please subscribe and click the bell icon also. And if you like the video, please share with others. We can go to the video. To make the Google form, first we have to sign. We can sign into the Google Drive. There, where we have to make the Google form, open that folder. I am making this Google form in 10B Maths Classroom. There, right click. From the option, select Google Form, or in the new button, select the Google Form. Google Form will be created. The untitled Google Form, we have to give the name. In this video, we are going to make the password protected Google Form. So we are giving password protected form. So same name we are giving here. Whatever name you want to give, no problem. You can give that name. And both place you can give same name or different name. And when you open, you can see only one question tile here. This is question tile. In this question tile, we will ask the children to type their password. Okay, when they open, they will see the first question tile. This is that first question tile. There we have to type, we have to ask the children, what's your password? Or type your password. Password or passcode. If you are typing only digit, you type a passcode. Or if you want to give a word as a password, you write password. Now I'm going to give only a number. Okay, that's why passcode. Just below you can see automatically came one text box, short answer text. And it must be, the first thing is it must be required. Otherwise they will go to the next section without the password. Okay, required. Next is very important thing. We have to click in the three dot, then select a response validation. In this response validation, when you select response validation, you can see number greater than, then here we can select the word text. If you select a text, we can type the password, and if you select the number, you can type the number here. Okay, and which number greater than or equal to or between, whichever you can. I am selecting here equal to. Equal to which number? Any number you can give. I'm giving you 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This number, okay? And one important thing, teachers, custom error text. This is very important, custom error text. If you keeping this text box blank, it is very problem, because when the children getting this page, the Google will tell the password, because Google doesn't know what message they have to give. So it will give something like 1 2 3 4 5 6. That message will get the children. So if they are typing that password, they can enter. So don't forget to type any raw any message. When they are typing this message, they will see. So I am typing here. Sorry dear, it's a wrong password, passcode. Okay, this is, it's a wrong passcode. This will show, okay, as a message when they are typing wrong passcode. For that, this is very important. Okay, now the passcode section over. Actually passcode section over, then this is a section. Actually, we have to make a next section. In the next section only, we have to create the questions, all the questions and the
options. Okay, for that we have to click in the section, add section, to know how to add the section and how to make a Google Forms and Google quiz program. You watch my previous video. Okay, now I am adding the section. Now we can see one new section has come. This is first section, section 1 of 2, and this is section 2 of 2. So two sections are there. Here we can give the real heading. Okay, general quiz. Okay, that is if it is the heading, you can type that heading according to your subject. Then after that we can add one question. Then here question you have to type question number 1, and here option we can take multiple choice or drop down. Okay, no problem, but usually we are taking option 1, 2, 3, 4, which we can see 1, option 2, option 3, option 4. Here you have to type the answers, and remember only the answer you have to type in the option number 1. Okay, that always you keep in mind. If you don't know why this one, please watch my previous video. If it is like that, very easily we can complete, we can finish the Google form. Okay, this will be the answer always. Don't forget to make this required. And one more thing, go to shuffle option order. These two things is very important. Not two things, three things. First one option, first one only answer. Second one required. Third one is a shuffle option order. Now we can check our Google form with the password protected form preview. It will ask type your passcode. If children are asking wrong passcode, it will tell sorry dear, it's wrong passcode. So we have type 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So now it will go to the next section. See, option 1 answer is this one. We can submit. So this is the method to give the passcode to a Google form.
I hope you understood easily how to make the Google form with a password. It is very easy. I think you also understood this is very easy process. When you make the Google form for the children, you add one more section in the beginning and add the password. But there are different levels. There are different levels for adding the passwords. That also we have to study later. You should understand what are those levels, because children are very smart. They know how to take the password from the Google form, and they know how to read the questions and options without a password. Even though you are locking or blocking the Google form with a password, some children can take these options and questions without the password. Even the password also they can take. Okay, that is method is there. So that also we have to block. That also we have to stop children, okay? How to block and how to stop the children from taking the or hacking the Google form. That we can learn in the next class or in the next video. Till then, goodbye.